everyone, and welcome to another episode of Mission Snapshot. We're so glad that you are here joining us today, and we're super excited to share with you some Bible worker stories. So Sharon and I have decided to switch it up a little bit, so I'm going to be your host for today, and Sharon will be dropping links in the description in the comments below, and also answering any comments or questions that you might have. So we're really excited today because we get to play with the JFA Now set a little bit, which is especially decorated for the Thanksgiving special that will be coming shortly. They filmed it yesterday, and so we get to have this nice fall set to remind us of Thanksgiving and how much we have to be thankful for.
Yes.
Especially these Bible stories show us a lot about that. So we're really excited to share them and really excited for Christina to be here. And I'm really excited to hear the stories that you have to share. So where are we going today?
Today our stories are coming from the Theni section.
Okay.
And that is in the western part of the Tamil Nadu state of India, in southern India.
Okay, so it's in the southwest sort of portion of India. Okay.
Yes.
So what's your first story?
Okay. Well, my first story is about a young boy who stood up to his father.
Oh,
and his father listened. Mm-hmm. But it starts with the mother met our Bible worker and was asking for prayer and sharing her story.
Mm-hmm.
And interestingly enough, she's praying earnestly for her husband.
Mm-hmm.
The reason is because he was an alcoholic.
Mm-hmm.
So he was not helping her, giving her money to support the family. He wasn't doing anything but drinking with the money he had. And not
That's
only
really frustrating.
That, though, he was coming home drunk and beating her.
Mm.
So it was a really bad situation she was in.
That sounds like it.
Right. So our Bible worker, her name's Joy, and was praying with her.
Mm-hmm.
And one day the husband came home prior to this, came home and actually beat her so bad she was unconscious.
Oh, how awful.
This was in front of their children.
In front of their children. Wow.
Yeah. So it really upset the children, naturally.
Mm-hmm.
And so the next
day...
Sure. Their oldest boy, who was only in third grade, actually confronted his father and told him, you know, that if you don't stop drinking, I'm going to run away. And I don't know where I'm going to go. I'll probably die somewhere, but I'm leaving.
Wow.
And then he asked his father, you know, what would have happened if mommy didn't wake up?
Mm-hmm.
You know, because he saw his mom unconscious on the floor. And what if she didn't wake up?
Yeah, what would have happened to their family?
What if she had died?
Yeah.
Yeah, who would have taken care of them?
Mm-hmm.
And so God used this little boy and spoke really deeply to this man's heart.
Wow.
And so he changed. He made a decision, a switch clicked in his brain or something. He made a firm decision that he wasn't going to drink anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And so that was 2 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And he hasn't drank anymore.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's really exciting.
So this family is learning about Jesus and growing, and we just want to keep them in their prayers.
Yes.
In our prayers.
We definitely do. That's amazing how... The mom prayed for her husband and for her family, and God used this child to really make the impact. That's really cool.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
He said, yeah.
So what's your second story?
Okay. My second story is about a woman who was very sick. She had a lot of things going on with her.
Mm-hmm.
Which is common even here in America. She had probably diabetes. She had heart problems. And she had some breathing problems. And so, but probably the diabetes she also had walking problems, which could have been because of the uncontrolled diabetes, neuropathy, things that come from that.
Mm-hmm.
So someone took her to the hospital and they actually admitted her because, you know, everything, all of her levels were, they had to take some time to get medication that would help control these problems she was having. And got her more stable, and they discharged her home, but she still didn't have any help, and she still was having trouble walking.
So it really didn't do any good for her at all, basically.
At least not
much.
Right. Right. She's still needing a lot of help.
Mm-hmm.
Well, our bio worker heard about her, and they began visiting her, the husband and wife, and praying with her and encouraging her and helping her, I'm sure, as we know our Bible workers do. And then she started feeling better in her legs. She started to be able to walk again. And so now she's able to take care of herself.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yes.
That God did that for her.
Yeah, she's not needing all the help that she needed.
Yeah, and she can see that God did it because, you know, clearly what she was doing before, unfortunately, wasn't helping. So she can see that, like, God was the solution that she needed, which is really cool.
Absolutely. And then they are able to testify to all their neighbors about, because like we've talked about before, everyone in the village knows what's going on in the other homes, basically.
Yeah. And just to get to share the gratitude that she has for the changes in her life must be so, so awesome, that testimony to have.
Okay. Yeah. So I have another story.
Okay.
And it's about an older man.
Okay.
And he had a lot of problems with his eyes. They would like water all the time and they'd hurt.
Strange.
And everyone thought he was sad all the time. Aww. Well, he was, I mean, he was in pain and he was sad. And so he was sharing with our Bible worker his situation and what was going on. And he hadn't been able to find anything that would help. And so our Bible worker shared with him the story in Luke where Jesus healed a blind man and encouraged him and prayed with him. And this guy accepted Jesus as his savior. He wanted to know Jesus and he believed in Jesus. And right then his eyes started to feel better.
Wow.
They weren't miraculously healed, but he could tell the pain went away. The tears were lessening. And so he knew that God had heard his prayer and cared about him. And so his prayer for us is that we pray for his family too, because he wants his whole family to know about Jesus. And he hopes that they can all be baptized together soon.
Yeah, we definitely need to keep that in our prayers. Because, yes. What's your next story?
Okay, my next story is about a mother who had a prayer request for her children. Specifically her daughter. Her daughter had run away with a young man and eloped.
Oh, okay.
And this was devastating to the family.
Because in India, usually, they have arranged marriages. And
right. So
for someone to just go off on their own, even more than in America, where it's kind of becoming a little bit more common, that's like a big deal for them. So that I can understand why they'd be like upset knowing how the Indian culture is.
Yes. And also she's heartbroken because she's missing her daughter.
Oh, of course.
So all that together. Mm-hmm. And so she is asking for prayer for her daughter, that they come back, that they're safe. And they come back home. Mm-hmm. And they did. They did come back home. God heard their prayer. They came back home. And there was, you know, obviously lots of conversations about this boy and the situation and everything. But eventually they did decide that the boy and the young girl could live together. Because I think sometimes in India, they get married young, or these arranged marriages are in place. But then it's still some time before they actually live together as husband and wife. Mm-hmm. So anyway, so they were allowed to live together.
Okay.
Even though they're kind of young.
But the family was able to accept and know that the young man had good intentions for their daughter, which is a good thing.
Right, right. Yeah. It was a process, I'm sure. Lots of conversations.
Yes, I'm sure.
So anyway, so this family is giving credit to God for bringing their daughter home and is telling people about it and giving all the praise to God. But then sadly, the son has now done the same thing. He's run off with a girl and disowned his family, per se. And so now they're praying for him, but they haven't given up on God.
That's good, because he clearly showed them last time that he cares about their family and being unified. So we just need to keep praying, and then that the son will come back, because I'm sure it's still really hard for that. I mean,
yes.
Yeah. So.
Okay. I have one more story. One more story about a family who has their own, like a shop, a business, and they were struggling with all the lockdown, with the COVID restrictions and how that's changed life for so many people. Their business was really going down. But unfortunately, this husband had also taken out a loan to be able to build a home for his family. So he was really concerned about not being able to pay the debt.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah.
And so he asked for prayer from the Bible worker, and they're praying together and encouraging. And, you know, he sees the business start to pick up, but then he also sees his son gets really sick. His young boy gets sick with a fever and ends up in the hospital for a little while.
That's really scary, especially with everything going on.
Right.
But yeah. So what did, how did they respond? What happened?
Well, they continued to pray.
They
were positive and believe in God, even though they weren't seeing again those instantaneous mm-hmm. answers to prayer. They stuck with it and mm-hmm. they continued to pray. Mm-hmm. We don't know the end of this story. You know, mm-hmm. we're not sure how it's all going to turn out, but we know the family, you know, wants to know more about Jesus and it's growing.
Yeah, I'm sure like a lot of us, I can learn a lot from that because sometimes it's really easy to start doubting God when right. things don't happen exactly the way we want, when we want it to.
Exactly.
But to trust that he has a plan and that he's going to take care of us because he is. He promised he would.
Right. So we have to trust in that love. And mm-hmm. and that's good. We don't always, I mean, it's hard for us, but I think it's even harder for them sometimes because mm-hmm. they don't have that in their religion per se, that their yeah. gods care about them.
Yeah, that's true. And they're such new believers. Like they're just learning. They don't have, you know, years of experience. It's like they have this testimony of God helping their shop, and you know, but that's you know, that's enough for them to trust, you know.
Right, because sometimes we could just blow that off as just coincidental too, but mm-hmm. they're choosing to be faithful, so.
and choosing to say that's evidence that God is going to
yes.
take care. He's going to continue to take care of our debt. He's going to continue to take care of our son. So that's really amazing.
To walk in faith.
Yeah, to walk in faith. Something we all need.
Yes.
Yes. So thank you so much for sharing these stories.
You're welcome.
They've been a huge blessing. And so, yeah, we're really glad always to share stories like these. So now these Bible workers from Theni, we mm-hmm. have actually shared before an introduction. So if you'd like to learn a little bit more about how the Theni Bible workers got started, Sharon will drop a link to that below. But these specific Bible workers were sponsored to enter an area that didn't have any workers
right.
To go into that area by our local church. And so the church is supporting their work and praying for them and, you know, getting to see also now some of the miracles that God is doing and the blessings that he is giving to the people in Theni because of their support, which is a really cool and amazing thing to be able to connect in that
yes.
way with the work the Bible workers are doing. So if you or your church would be interested in sponsoring some Bible workers to enter some entered areas just like these Bible workers, we will leave our email in the comments below and you can get in contact with us about that if you have a desire to be a part of that and to connect with a group of Bible workers. And if you would like to support other Bible workers who are doing work like this throughout India, we will also drop a link to our Bible worker page. And we just ask that you please keep these Bible workers in your prayers.
Yes.
As we've talked about, they have a lot of faith and they share that with the people that they are ministering to. But they also need a lot of encouragement because sometimes they face really huge challenges.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just want to always keep them in our prayers that God will fortify them and that he'll open the hearts of the people like he did with the husband
right.
who was abusive. He changed his heart because of the prayers of his wife. And so we know that he'll change more people's hearts if we pray. So if you would like to learn more about any of our other projects, you can visit our website at jesusforasia.org. And there you can view our more than 60 projects in many categories, not just Bible workers, but also evening schools and missionaries and education and media ministry. And we're sure that you'll find something that resonates with you. And as you go through the list, we just ask you to pray for those projects as well. And see how God might lead you to get involved, but also just to know that they need prayer and support as well, just in their ministries because mm-hmm. they also go through challenges. And so if you would like to, if you haven't already, we welcome you to subscribe to our YouTube channel or like our page on Facebook so then you can find out the next time that we post a new episode. And once again, we thank you for joining us and we thank Christina for sharing these stories. And this has been your Mission Snapshot.